In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to make these adorable rack dividers.
Toss in here, baby. As a fashion boom.
I like to organize my closet by categories, but I needed a way to organize my subcategories, so I thought the rack dividers would be the perfect way to do that.
Cut yourself a Columbine.
Here's what you'll need. You'll need a brush. This one is actually an old foundation brush. You're gonna need a stencil, and the one I have here is actually below. You can click the link and print it out if you want to do this project. Your favorite patterned scrapping book paper. There's so many to choose from at the arts and crafts store. A handy dandy pencil. Any recycled box that you could find. I'm using a cereal box, and I'm also using an old computer laptop box. Mod Podge glue. And a pair of scissors. First, we're going to be printing out the stencil that we're going to be using. And like I said, I did put the link below to the stencil that we're using here so you can print it out yourself.
Touch the ground.
Now it's time to pick which scrap paper you want to use for your rack divider.
Someday you'll have to fall, and you can find me standing there.
After you have cut your stencil out, we're going to use it to trace behind the scrapping paper.
Toss it here, baby, as a fashion move.
Next, we're going to cut out that scrapping book paper that we just traced it over, and we're going to again do it on the other scrapping book paper so we can have two sides to the rack divider. Now we're going to use that box to put in the middle of our rack divider so it could be more sturdy, and we're going to trace over that.
Won't buy your dreams for you. Cut yourself.
Now it's time to glue our stencils together. This brush I'm using is actually an old foundation brush, and I'm just dipping it into my Mod Podge glue and just applying it all over the stencil cardboard box that we just cut out.
Watch the petals dancing. See them twirl and say, now in pride and prancing. How much does it mean? The petals start to fly, and then come fall.
Once you glue your stencils together, this is what it should look like. Make sure you put some weight over your stencil once it's all glued up, just for a couple of minutes so it can hold together better. Once you're all done, all that's left to do is decorate your stencil. And this is like the funnest part of the video. And feel free to decorate your stencil according to the decor in your room because it looks super duper cute.
Toss in here, baby, as a fashion boom. All in that you're saving. Won't buy your dreams for you.
So that was it for my video today. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for more DIY videos, and don't forget to watch my last video.